Amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound
that saved a wretch like me.
That saved a wretch like me.
I was lost, but now I'm found.
I once was lost, but now I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see.
Was blind, but now.
Okay, this is for Chuck Connors. Made a video. He made a video earlier today. I'll put a link to it. I don't have the title of it. He was asking for Bible stories, your favorite Bible stories. And I want to offer this to you, Chuck. The so you're speaking in front of people at your church and that kind of thing, and that's a great thing. There's a lot of courage to do it, but it's really a good thing. It's great for your faith. Yeah, you'll get more out of it than anybody, and in that, people will get something out of it. And so I admire the fact that you're putting yourself through that to do that. But let me first make this statement. As far as faith and being a Christian and seeking righteousness and all this stuff, I am a failure at my faith. Okay, I am the as far as being the biggest screw up Christian I've ever met. Okay, and no one needs salvation more than I do. Okay, so if I'm offering you some tips or advice that you might be able to use, but I'm not saying it as some self righteous individual who thinks he's got this all figured out. I just want to put that out there first. I'm in a mistake right now. If you have a problem finding things to, if someone said, listen, we're going to let you come speak in front of the congregation for half hour, 45 minutes, whatever it is, and you're trying to figure out, gee, what will I talk about? A good way to get around that is it's always best if you have revelation. And revelation for me always came from reading. The more you read your Bible on a regular basis, the more you'll have plenty of stuff to talk about. And I don't mean going into your Bible, digging stuff up, and that kind of thing. On a daily basis, you open that thing up and read it. And when I say read it, I don't mean try to figure it out, interpret it, look for this code, look for just read, just hear the words. You want those words to go into your head and onto your heart and let them do their thing. If you do that regularly, the problem won't be what to talk about, which what not to talk about, because you'll have so much in there that comes out at you. You won't be able to shut up about it. So just reading on a regular basis, 15, 20 minutes a day, but that's it, just reading it, hearing those words in your mind, let them float around in there. Well, try to figure it out. I spent all my time in this Bible trying to, figure I got all, dialed in. I don't know anything. You have to excuse the dogs. But if you're having trouble figuring out what to talk about, you need to read more in your Bible. The other thing, nobody likes a Bible thumper. No one likes to be told what to do, even though we need it. No one wants someone that says, it says here, you need to soften your heart, so turn your heart back to to God, and you'll get your blessings and all this. I should have looked at the verse I'm just thinking of. But nobody wants to hear it like that. Some guys can do that and pull it off. Some guys are good teachers that way. But most people would rather hear your testimony. Okay? How are you applying this book in your life, in your walk? And more often they want to hear about, not so much about your successes, but about your failures. People would rather hear, stuff that they can use and they can relate to. Most people don't really think they can relate to their preacher, because he's a preacher. He must have this thing all dialed in. I might be clueless and not get this figured out yet. So if you talk about yourself and your walk, people get a lot out of that. Your testimony is everything. And doesn't have, your testimony doesn't have to be some perfect thing, because we're not perfect. We're all a mess. But when you share your experiences, people learn so much from that. I can't think of the verse, but there's many verses in the Old Testament that says, you know, if you soften your hearts, turn back to your Father in heaven, everything will go accordingly. Right now, a great example. We've got this thing going on in my family with this estate, family split. It's gone to attorneys. They're fighting this thing. I got another family member I'm trying to take care of, dealing with his estate and everything. He's still alive, but he's sick. And I'm dealing with attorneys that I can't work with. I'm dealing with him that I can't work with. I'm dealing with the banks and some family members. I mean, every turn there's garbage I got to put up with. And I got my own mess to take care of, okay? And so in the middle of all this stress and junk and all the stuff I got to deal with, which I'm pretty ticked off, but I have to deal with it, to be honest with you. I have a list of people that I am currently, I can resent. I resent them, okay? And they've made me angry. And I see not one train wreck. I see several train wrecks coming for me, because this thing's not getting any better, okay? And the mistake I've made, you might say, well, that happens to everybody, you know, so that's just the way life is. And it is. That's the way life is. The mistake I've made is in this battle, this last couple of months of all these things I've had to deal with, is I have not consulted, I don't know if that's the right word, I've not consulted my faith on how I am to deal with all this. I've not prayed on it. I've not asked my Father in heaven, hey, how do I deal with this? And I have not acted accordingly to the teachings of Jesus as stated in Matthew 5, 6, and 7. I've just gone rogue and I'm dealing with this thing all by myself. And because I'm not following the teachings of Jesus, and I have not, and I have hardened my heart in resentment towards these people. Remember, soften your heart, turn back to the Father. He has left me alone in all this, and I am getting my ass kicked because I've not turned back to my Father. I've made all kinds of, I can look back now and say, man, I've made nothing but mistakes in this thing. I've not asked for help. I've not followed the teachings of Jesus, and I'm getting eaten alive in the world today. Okay, that's my testimony. So instead of, I could say, hey, you all need to eat your hearts, you know, soften your hearts, turn back to your Father. And no one would listen to me. But when I tell you the mistake I'm making, I got a rock in my chest, and I am pissed off at all these people. And maybe rightly so. But that's not what Jesus gave me. That's not the teachings that he's given me. That's not the direction I'm going to be heading in. But because I've walked away from my faith, away from those teachings, I'm going to get that's the result I'm going to get. Because I have not softened my heart and turned back to my Father and listened to his Son. See, and I need to straighten that out, because I got a big mess going on over here, and got to humble myself. I got to admit, hey, I got a problem. I've done this thing all wrong. See, anyway, that's my testimony. As a believer, we all have problems, okay? And if you are going to speak to people and want to help others, that kind of thing, don't try to be impressive. Don't try to, you know, you got some special thing figured out, whatever. Unless you got revelation, unless you got something that's given to you from above, then you share that. But there's so much in our daily walk, in our daily life, that we go through where we either apply the Bible and we can see the benefit of it, where we're getting the assistant and the blessings, or see where we've gone rogue, got off and done our own thing, and getting our butts kicked. And then we get the revelation out of that, okay, I'm on the wrong path again. I've messed up. I need to, you know, straighten myself up and get back on track. Anyway, I hope that makes sense. If you read your Bible more often, I mean, you might read it every day, but just read it. Just hear those words in here. Let those words float around in your head. Get your New Testament out, whatever you're reading. But don't try to figure it out. Don't try to get it all, you know. The word's a powerful thing. And when there's something in that you need to know, it'll let you know. You'll know what you need to talk about. I'll put a link down below to a John Piper video. I think I promoted this once before. I like the guy. I don't necessarily agree with what he agrees with, his church or whatever. But this particular teaching's it's a 47-minute video. The first 16 minutes, all he does is recite verses out of the Bible. And you might think, okay, I get this, but what's he doing it for? After 16 minutes, he explains to you what he's doing. Has very powerful teaching after that. And I'll put a link down to it. You get some time, check it out. Very worthwhile video. But whatever you do, keep doing what you're doing. If they give you a time slot, you get to speak in front of the people, man, get out there and do it. Because that's walking your faith. That's working it. And that's good stuff. Anyhow, love you, brother. God bless. Hopefully this might help you.